We interrupt this program for a special news bulletin. These startling images are coming live to us from Moscow. Hard information is sketchy at this time, but it appears that a renegade Russian army division...
Switch cameras on my mark.
...troll the nuclear missile installation outside Moscow. All communication in and out of the area has been...
Get away from me. Go to commercial now.
Go to commercial.
That last piece of tape, I shot it myself from the top of a hotel in Baghdad 6 years ago.
Yes.
Enjoy the show. I made it myself.
Who the hell is this?
Just the guy who psyched out 60 million people.
Do you have any idea what the FCC penalties for this are?
Can't prosecute a guy you can't catch.
Why are you doing this?
Some people climb mountains, some hike across Alaska, but I don't like all that cold weather. Look, I gotta go, but keep your eyes open, because what's gonna happen next? Let's just say in 50 years, kids will be reading about me in the history books.
A high-end art and jewel thief. A master of the short con and martial arts. A hacker Robin Hood who stole from the rich to give to the poor. The organization's job is to protect the status quo. You three are each the best at what you do. Now you will do it for us.
Last night, the American television audience believed civil war was breaking out in Russia. Video feeds were forged and broadcast. Confirmation calls were faked. For roughly 9 minutes, our national news gathering network was completely subverted.
What were you doing last night?
Yeah, sounds like the kind of stunt you'd pull.
No, if it was Marcus, millions of people would have received free shower radios.
Did you just make a joke?
Before they realized the unrest in Russia wasn't real, the U.S. government placed its theater defense missiles at DEFCON 3.
What does a media hoax have to do with us?
I'm not sure, but the individual who's claiming responsibility contacted us.
He knows about the organization.
Apparently.
That's it. Cover's blown. Shred the files. We can go home now.
Not just yet. The individual wants to talk to us.
This is a test of the emergency broadcast system. For the next 60 seconds, you are gonna get really, really scared. I'm sorry, but a guy's gotta get his kick somewhere.
Who are you?
Why don't you ask Marcus? Remember me, buddy?
Maybe if you show me your face, it would jar something loose.
Why don't we just stick to my nickname? You gave it to me a few years ago after that train wreck.
Avatar?
You know this guy?
Used to.
Things kind of soured after that railroad thing, right, Marcus?
He tapped into a switching system, caused two commuter trains to collide.
A warm-up.
People died.
I never could have done it without you. If they gave out Oscars for what I do, I would have you to thank.
You lost it, man.
So Marcus started you out as a hacker.
A hacker is a typist, Ms. Webb.
Yeah, and what are you?
Today, nobody. Tomorrow, immortal. Ours is a lonely path. Right, Marcus? Who said that again?
The Silver Surfer.
Yeah.
Why don't you cut to the chase? What do you have planned this time?
I'm gonna level a major American city exactly 24 hours from now.
Another stunt.
It'll be the ultimate stunt, because it'll be real.
Why tell us?
Because of me.
The student surpassing the teacher is a time-honored rite of passage. And I will surpass you, Marcus.
In your dreams.
Sorry, but I gotta go. I got something in the oven.
He's bluffing. Right, Marcus?
You want to take that bet?
So look, we call the CIA, the FBI, one of those other three-letter agencies and get them involved.
The organization's anonymity is to be preserved at all costs.
At all costs. Excuse me, but didn't Nutboy say something about a major American city being leveled?
24 hours isn't much time. Better get moving. Good luck.
Ours is a lonely path, right, Marcus? Ours is a lonely path, right, Marcus? Who said that again?
Is he okay?
Ours is a lonely path,
be?
Right, Marcus? Who said that again?
Marcus,
I had something
to you ever, actually meet this guy?
No, never. I just called him by a screen name. Got to know each other over a couple of years.
I had something
to bit of cyber bonding.
I showed him some tricks. Backmodeming, password breaking, firewall penetration, basic stuff, you know?
Yeah, sure.
The stuff I taught him isn't anything he couldn't have learned on his own. I got him started, so I'm gonna stop him. He's not surpassing anybody.
I had something in the oven.
Obsessing for hours over the same bit of videotape's not gonna help.
I gotta go now. I had something in the oven.
God, he's on our side.
All right, all I need to do is find a match. Billings, Montana. Police picked him up under the name Miles ENIAC.
Alias.
ENIAC was the name of the first electronic computer. He was arrested for possession of an unregistered 9mm. Fined and let go.
So now we've got a deranged geek with firepower.
Can you get more from the police files? Like, I don't know, an address or something?
What do you think?
There's a map of every major American city up here.
This guy's serious.
Or maybe not.
Ooh, a healthy buildup of keyboard plaque.
Disgusting.
Hello, Marcus. You just triggered a sealed mercury pressure switch. If you try to get up or even shift your weight too fast, you're history. If you sit really still, you buy yourself 3 minutes. And then you're history. Sorry, dude.
Don't move.
And, don't even think about trying to hack my computer.
Talk about some acid rain.
He's got this whole place rigged to be bathed in acid.
Did he ever tell you guys about what he did to me after that train incident?
He doesn't talk about you much. Maybe some other maniacs made a bigger impression.
He sent the FBI to my house. The front porch was booby-trapped, though. I think the two agents barely survived.
Hate to be the Avon lady in your neighborhood.
Where are you?
in the city I targeted, but not for much longer. I don't like the heat much. And Marcus, seriously, I'm sorry. But I gotta do this.
Okay, I found the feed pipe.
And the shut-off valve?
Negatory.
Well, take your time. We got well over 29 seconds. Will you all get out of here now?
You know, he's probably got a point. We ought to get out of here. Just leave him here.
Well, there's no honor among thieves. And besides, he gets so testy at moments like this.
Please stop talking and tell me you can beat the damn mercury switch.
No way. This is nice work. Oh, it's expensive, too. He's obviously got one hell of a trust fund. 5 seconds.
Okay, I'll take the pipe.
I've got Grumpy.
How you doing? Trying to remember to breathe. How much longer do we have?
Oh, 17 hours.
I don't think we're gonna pull any leads out of this thing.
Marcus, you know the Avatar. Maybe not his face, but if anyone can get inside his head, it's you.
You're right. I'm a computer prodigy. A narcissistic, paranoid little...
No, Marcus. He means think like the Avatar.
All right, I've plotted this for years. I sit at this desk, look at all these maps, all these different cities, till finally I pick one. Every day I look at the same maps, see what I'm gonna come up with. I look for weaknesses in the infrastructure, try and conjure up all these different doomsday scenarios. I roll back and forth staring at the same map until I've worn a path into the floor. Now, I could measure the minute contour shifts if I had a laser.
Sorry, I've left mine at the office.
Yeah, we might need something just a little bit simpler.
Yeah.
Get it?
Sure. I was just about to suggest the same thing.
Whoa. Judging from the level of the keyboard and the height he set on the chair, he'd be staring at Denver.
Department of Transportation hasn't cleared any hazardous materials for transit through Denver. No chemical weapons, no nuclear waste, no high explosives. Nothing in large enough quantities to inflict any major damage.
Not even a Who's the Boss marathon on cable? Oh, sorry, I'm just trying to keep us from getting very depressed around here.
Can he poison the water supply?
Level. Level. He said something about leveling a city. What else?
Something about it getting very hot.
That's right, he did. About 10,000 degrees hotter. Something tells me that news hoax wasn't just to get attention. He wanted the government to put the nukes on alert so he could tap into their communications, download their latest routines.
What routines?
Launch routines for nuclear missiles.
Are you sure he's not taking you for a big ride?
Hey, listen, man. Have we had much luck betting against him so far?
What do we do now?
Well, for starters, we get our hands on a couple thousand dollars worth of proprietary phone company equipment.
Sorry, guys. Nothing personal. I just... don't like country.
The only way for the Avatar to launch a missile
was through a Defense Department trapdoor.
Oh, let me guess. I'm the only one small enough to fit through it.
It's a digital trapdoor.
I knew that.
Really?
No.
Now, he'd have to figure out some way to modem instructions to an Air Force computer trunk line.
First, we have to find military unlisted trunk numbers.
Is that hard?
Not with this puppy. Flash ROM command level. Mobile switching center.
The launch routine's a big file. It would take at least 20 minutes to download this.
So then, is that it? Boom?
Once his routine's downloaded, it'll take a few hours to crack passwords, circumvent all internal security measures. Once that's done, then boom.
And is there no other way the Avatar can launch the missile?
There might be, but that's the way I'd do it. What?
You've made one hell of a real crook.
God, if there was only some way to harness him for the good of criminal kind.
Has anyone ever told you how twisted you both are?
Aside from you?
Oh, my God.
You found something.
Someone's sending something. Hold on, let me cross-check. Damn! He's downloading the launch routine.
Cut off the transmission.
I can't. I got a location across town.
Coming from a payphone on the plaza level.
Left on his transmission.
He's beaten me at my own game.
But this is not your fault.
I know that.
You're not responsible
for what he's doing.
I know that. I just want to catch this punk so I can get home, read my Japanese comic books. Nothing personal.
Sure.
You read Japanese comic books too?
I got him. South side wall. It's a TDD.
I'll be home for dinner.
Sorry. False alarm. How much time left now?
38 seconds.
I got an idea.
What are you doing?
Well, you said he's downloading from a payphone, right?
Yeah.
So for the next few seconds, he can't run, no matter what.
He's done things with machine code I've never seen before.
Could we drop the Appreciation Society and just stop the missile?
We aren't appreciating it. We're trying to understand it so we can undo it.
Sorry.
4 hours.
Got milk?
Tell us how to stop the launch, and maybe we'll let you go in one piece.
Back to what? That dump I live in? You saw it. No way.
Then this is gonna get bad.
What are you gonna do, Jonathan? Steal my watch?
You don't want to know.
Yawn.
Listen, you and I know you don't really want to kill 500,000 people.
Sorry, but I'm not good looking. I'm not rich. I'm not related to anybody famous. This is the only way I know to get out of that little room and into the history books.
Is it better?
Yeah. Will you be playing the role of the good cop today?
Listen, geek boy, I don't think like you. I didn't run the slide projector in high school, but I do know how to do some things very, very well.
I can touch my nose with my tongue.
Ooh, and I can really, really hurt somebody. I can take you to the point just before you pass out, and then start all over again. It's funny.
No, it's just that I usually don't get this close to women. I think I kind of like it.
I got in. He's programmed it to erase itself.
Yeah, I thought you'd like that. Would you like to know how I did it? You and I had some good times. Remember the time we took America offline?
Yeah, that was a prank.
Or the White House gag? One time, he rerouted a bunch of 976 phone sex numbers straight to the president's line.
Really?
You never told us about that one, Marcus.
But nothing beats this. And if it wasn't for you starting me off, I would never have been able to do this.
You listen to me. You said I made you. I can unmake you, piece by piece. Now I want you to tell me how to stop the launch. And I want you to tell me now!
Not personal.
I don't think I want that mind of yours set to the task of making me crack, so I think I'll see you in 24 hours. And by then, I'll be the teacher, and you'll be the student.
Hey, he's got something in his mouth. Hey!
He's still breathing. Okay. Oh. Oh, God.
What is it?
Triptazone. Used on patients who are in shock. He'll be out at least for another 24 hours.
Well, all right, forget the man. Let's just call the CIA and get them to shut down all the nukes.
With what proof? Huh? I'm sure Avatar wrote his computer programs in camouflage style. Any activity on his computer is gonna look normal until the launch of the missiles.
And look who's asking. Three criminals.
Two criminals. Two criminals are gonna call them and ask them to shut down the U.S. nuclear defense systems.
If only we had five more hours.
Any ideas, Marcus?
Yeah. We know what base Avatar sent the launch routine to. We'll call ourselves.
Where the hell is this guy? His flight plan sends him right over us.
Anytime you want to tell us what you're talking about, Marcus, we're here.
I'm sending a mock military aircraft distress signal.
Two?
The officer in charge of the local nuclear missile installation.
And that would be?
General Lee Buck Williamson.
Oh, and you came across this piece of information because...
Amanda, I use this bad boy for more than just downloading unlisted military numbers.
Because you actually knew ahead of time that we'd need this.
Because I could. Do either one of you know the difference between a hacker and a cracker?
Let's see. A cracker would be a psycho nerd type that wants to blow up cities.
And a hacker wouldn't want anything to do with that, hey, Marcus?
You're exactly right. A hacker would never go through with it, but he sure as hell would want to know how to do it.
Why?
It's all about data, girl. Finding it, collecting it, getting it.
Also, knowledge isn't power. megabytes are.
If I wanted power, I'd motor myself a couple hundred million, spend the rest of my life doing whatever I wanted to anyone I wanted.
Can you really do that?
It's not what I got this stuff for.
I respect that, Marcus.
Thank you.
I do. Could you do it for me?
Whatever I use my computer for, it's got to be right. Period.
How does the 976 White House joke fit into that category?
See, like, we were talking about stuff I did after high school. Can we stick to that?
Can we get back to the part about you modeming yourself a couple $100 million?
Sorry, no, and never.
You call us crazy.
That's because both of you are.
At least we don't collect military aircraft distress signals.
You know what? If this works, I think you should start.
If this works, I'll kiss your feet.
Oh, Jonathan, pucker up.
Sir, I've got an automated locator beacon coming from those woods down there. Originating from a Tupolev Tu-22M backfire. Russian spy plane. Want me to call base? Sit down, Captain. We got us a trophy deer in them woods, and I aim to bring it home on my fender.
Do you know what kind of federal brig time you people are facing? Hijacking a U.S. government aircraft? Hostage taking of military personnel?
Yeah, excuse me, sir, you can finish your list later. We need you to do something.
We need you to stand down a U.S. nuclear defense arsenal for the next 2 hours.
Is that all? Are you people nuts? The President of the United States can't do that without an act of Congress.
A false launch routine will trigger an ICBM within the next 2 hours.
And do you perhaps have any proof of this?
Oh, plenty we can show you after all this goes down.
You know how many crackpots contact me every day with the latest doomsday threat? If I reacted to every one of them, we'd be out of the defense business.
Well, you're gonna be out of the Denver business unless you shut up and do something.
Even if a missile did launch, we'd knock it out of the sky before it got 200 miles.
Will you listen? This crackpot you're referring to picked a silo within 150 miles of this target. This silo's gotta be around here.
Get him riled up and the man's good.
Knowledge of the exact location of nuclear missile sites is tantamount to treason and punishable by firing squad.
Oh, God, guys. Can we go? I mean, it's obvious that Buck here is never gonna believe us no matter what we say, because the guy is clueless.
You can tell it all to the prison psychiatrist. He knows all about little green men at Roswell and voices that talk to you through your dental fillings. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have places to go. And things to do.
Beat it, Buck.
We're making an unscheduled flight.
Well, I hope one of you guys is a pilot. I'm maintenance. This is the general's favorite helo. He asked me to ride along. Check out the control systems.
Great. We've kidnapped Mr. Goodwrench.
Hey!
Oh, man of many talents. Let's get out of Dodge. Okay. Staying within 150 miles of Denver makes this the only candidate, Silo 51.
Marcus, you never told us you knew how to fly a helicopter. Why were you holding out on us?
Marcus?
You do actually know how to fly this, right?
Sure he can. He's doing it, flying.
Right away. Jump in here anytime, Marcus.
Simulator.
Sure, you probably spent a lot of time in the old simulator before you rode off in the real thing.
Flight simulator.
The computer game?
I hear they're remarkably similar.
How are you at landing?
I could have probably used a little bit more practice.
Okay, scale of 1 to 10, Marcus. 1 being absolutely no bodily damage, 5 being some severe mangling.
We're gonna die.
That would be 10.
We can't die. The silo goes online in 90 minutes. The Air Force defense systems will recognize this as a friendly aircraft and let us into the airspace above the silo in less than 15.
Okay, we can jump.
What? What are we supposed to do with the helicopter?
I don't know. Let it crash.
No way, man.
Yeah.
I'm gonna put it on autopilot. It'll run out of gas over the Great Salt Lake.
All right, kids. Let's bail.
Uh-uh.
What's the problem?
No problem. Just jumping out of this helicopter is the last thing I'm going to do.
What? You're afraid of heights?
No, I'm not. I have a fear of cloth filled with air combined with great heights.
Now look, you're upset.
No, I'm hysterical. I am not some little G.I. Jane doll you can just strap in and toss out of the little plane. Out she goes.
Stop whining.
Shut up.
I think she's still upset.
Silo 51. Just over that bridge. You ever broken into a nuclear silo before?
I don't think anyone ever has.
Any idea what we're up against?
My guess are sentries, satellite security, steel and concrete doors at least 3 feet thick. If we so much as make a peep, we'll have half of the military of this state on our backs in less than 3 minutes.
Well, they're your tax dollars at work.
You pay taxes?
It's a saying. Is there anything in here we could actually use?
Yeah, if you want to have a hoedown.
Well, we got 57 minutes. Hey, Marcus.
We could get killed.
Oh, and to think I've never seen Katz.
Tough guy, you know. What was that?
Now, how does this thing work?
The impact of the suction cup combines with the porous nature of the human cell structure.
Now!
It acts as a natural injector mechanism for the horse tranquilizer.
Cool. God, this guy's hearing some Pink Floyd.
How long will they be out?
About 20 minutes.
Denver's got about 10. Ooh, sorry.
Lunch.
What did you put in that?
Oh, a little of this, a little of that. Most of it passed through some cow's digestive tract.
Oh.
This is the part when I'd rather be doing something else.
That part started for me about 24 hours ago.
Let's move.
Technology kicks in, right?
Where the hell did they get all this new stuff?
New stuff?
Marcus, if this tape is playing, it means you really are the best. Congratulations. I mean, not that you're going to be able to stop what I've done. I just really hope you appreciate the achievement because it means a lot to me. Don't forget me, old buddy, because I can assure you, no one else will. Oh, and in case you're wondering, it was tripped as,
He knew that.
Launch in T-minus 2 minutes.
I can't shut it down from here.
Well, then from where? Support.
You don't have morals.
That's true.
I mean it. Get out of here. Go get the soldiers if something goes wrong
here. It won't. You're the best.
That's right. If he wasn't, we would be working with some other geek, right?
All right. I'm a genius.
You are brilliant. Better than the Avatar on his best day.
T-minus 11 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
You...
2, 1. Launch aborted.
Oh! You did that. You did that.
System reset. Launch in T-minus 2 minutes.
Damn! I planned for everything.
Look,
This missile's disarmed, right?
Yes, it is. But even if a warhead doesn't go critical, there's still enough radioactive materials and explosives on board to take out a square mile. And it's still launching.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna lock the missile in the silo.
I thought you said that thing was set to launch.
It is. It's gonna slam into the roof and explode. The silo's built to withstand that sort of blast.
I'm sensing a hitch here.
Yep. We're down here when it goes off. We're fried scrapple.
Get the other gun. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Congratulations. Millions owe you their lives.
But the organization's secret is still safe. That's the main thing, right?
You may think we're completely without empathy, but that's not entirely true.
Does this mean I gotta put you people on my Christmas list?
We live in a world precariously balanced on the edge of chaos. Our job is to see that it doesn't tip.
Tell me, if it come down to it, into choosing between protecting the anonymity of the organization or the people of Denver, who'd have lost?
Fortunately, Mr. Vance, that's a choice we no longer have to make. Good night.
Ours is a lonely path. Right, Marcus? Ours is a lonely path. Right, Marcus?